welcome to Political Matters and OPC TV Sunday's Communication. I welcome all of you to another new week, to a very sunny morning today. And so we are here at Ijegun to ask our interviewees to get their reactions concerning what was written on the Punch paper today, and also on the Vanguard. So today we'll be asking them about the IPOB and Biafran agitation. We'll be getting their reactions at what, as the Lagos State Commissioner of Police has come out to say that both IPOB and the Biafran people also are on their watch list. So don't go nowhere. When we come back, we'll be talking to our interviewees. We'll be back. Talk about what was written on the Vanguard newspaper this morning concerning the Oduwa Republic and also the Biafran. The Lagos State Commissioner of Police has come out to say that both the Oduwa Republic and both the Biafran are on their watch list. Let's quickly get your reactions concerning this.
The only thing is that the federal government cannot stop anybody of agitating of whatever they feel. We are in a democracy, so we are not in a military regime. So if the federal government, the Commissioner of Police of Lagos State said the Oduwa and the Biafran is on their watch list, I think it's making a very big mistake, because every individual in this country, I don't see in any, okay, if they are on their watch list, what of Arewa? So are they on their watch list as well? So it's only Oduwa and Biafran they are talking about. So what is happening in Nigeria now is not something that you know, any governor or any senator that will be talking about, because this is a free, we are in a free speech world. Everybody is free to do, to agitate whatever. If the poverty in Nigeria is killing people, people are free to agitate for improvement in the government to stop poverty in Nigeria. So now the people are agitating because things are not going well in Nigeria. Oduwa are agitating, the Biafran, they are agitating, they want to go on their separate way. So I don't see the reason why the federal government, the Commissioner of Police of Lagos State, will say that on their watch list, you know, to watch list meaning they are targeting them, they are watching them. So what are they trying to do to tell us about? So the Boko Haram is not in their watch list. You know, what is happening in the southeast is not on their watch list. So the poverty, the looting that is happening in Nigeria is not on their watch list. So what is on their watch list is when people are agitating. So like when NSAS came up, people agitate because they want SARS to end, because the SARS himself are killing people, you know, harassing the people of the country. So then the people came out in mass and begin to agitate. So you cannot stop. There is no nation, there is no country in the world that can stop anybody of agitating of whatever that he feel. If he feel like the government is not doing well, you are free to agitate. If you feel that the local government is not doing well, you are free to agitate. So there is no way you can put people on the watch. What is the meaning of that? If they are trying to do that, that means they are causing more calamity. The calamity that is happening here in Nigeria today is because of the way the federal government handled the issue. That is why the issue rises. Okay, look at what is happening in the southeast. It's because of the way the governor handled the issue. It did not bring the issue down. It did not calm it down. It just take it, you know, forming, putting fuel on it. That is why the issue get to that stage now. So now, no matter what he said that is on their watch list, it will not stop them of agitating. There is no way they can stop Oduduwa of agitating, because they want to go on their separate. What is the reason? The only thing they can do is to call these people on dialogue, call them on the round table, ask them, what is your problem? Why are you agitating? Then they will talk what is in their mind. They say, this is the reason why they agitated. So if it's something that they can solve, they will solve it. It's not that going after those people. You cannot go after those people. Government, how many of them is in number? So you cannot compare the masses that are crying, that are weeping. Look at how the poverty are intimidating, killing people. Things are very expensive. And people now, they are not happy what is going on in Nigeria. So that is why you see agitation is going all over the place. Last time, you see the houses. They are agitating. They are selling Buhari is a criminal. Buhari is a terrorist.
They are saying it. They are in Abuja. They are agitating. So why? Because of the government are not. They are not doing their responsibility. They have kept their responsibility. What they're supposed to do, you know. So now the people are suffering because we don't see. We are not getting any benefit in this country. We know how much they are selling fuel in 4 years in 6 years ago. But now how much is fuel?
You know, talking about the government keeping their responsibility. Just last week we heard about the story about the Boko Haram threatening to attack Aso Rock, and because of that there have been turmoil and fears in the hearts of many Nigerian leaders. Let me get your reactions concerning this, because very soon now, because we're talking about Niger last week, we talked about Kaduna, you know, about the adoption in Kaduna, and now slowly, gradually they are getting there, they are getting to Aso Rock. And they've said that they are threatening Boko Haram, precisely. They've threatened that they are going to attack Aso Rock. Let's see if you get a reaction concerning this.
Because the government have failed us. And Nigeria is bleeding. There are too much bleeding in Nigeria. There are too much blood. The blood, the innocent blood that I've shared in this country, is enough for the country to go their separate way. So look at what is happening in Niger. Boko Haram, what have the government done on Boko Haram? They have not brought these people to book. They have not ended the existence of Boko Haram to today, up to date. So now, look at Boko Haram mounting their flag in Niger State. So what are we talking about? Mounting their flag. And now they said they very soon they will come to Aso, they will come to Abuja. And when already they are in Abuja now. So now when they take when they came into Abuja now, so what is going to happen? So now Nigeria is not safe. There is no place that is safe because of the government are supporting the Boko Haram and the herdsmen. The government, they cannot deny it because we have known what is happening now. Now, the government that are sponsoring this Boko Haram, okay, look at, they talk about the Bumi, negotiating with the bandits, telling the federal government, if you people don't pay this money, that the Boko Haram will kill these people. So now, what have they done to the people, the person, the Bumi himself is in the government, and the government is not saying anything about that. The people are speaking, said they should bring Bumi to book. They should bring him to book. Then you know the people, the person that they are negotiating with the Boko Haram, you have not went to him to arrest him, to bring him to book. And you've been trusted of killing innocent people. You will send soldiers to go and kill innocent people that are without arms. So where are we going? So now, the Boko Haram that have manned their flag in Niger State, now they are in Abuja. I think last night or yesterday, the Boko Haram, they said it's a armed robber, you know, coming, entering inside the Aso Rock. Can you imagine that? Do you know the kind of security that is in Aso Rock? And they are telling us that the armed robber entered inside Aso Rock and invade Gambari's office in Aso Rock, and they scattered everywhere, take some of the documents, and then went away, just free like that. What government, which villa, which government in the war that the armed robber will enter? Do you know the kind of security that is in Aso Rock? That the armed robber will enter and rob and get away with it. This government is a very stupid government. They have failed. We know their mission. We know what they are doing. So they cannot deceive us anymore, because I don't see in a way that if the president is on siege and all these things will be happening. Last time there is a gunshot in Aso Rock, the government, the president did not speak anything about that. Now, the armed robber entered inside Aso Rock. What they told us, we know that it's herdsmen, we know that it's Boko Haram. Because very soon, the senators that are in Aso Rock, they will invade Aso Rock, they will capture everybody. And the Aso Rock will be taken over by the bandits. Then, we know that we have nowhere to go in this country. So now we know that the government himself, they are the reason, they are the problem of what we are facing here in Nigeria. They cannot deny that. And the world, the world are rejecting them from the assistance. They are demanding from the world. Now, about 2 days, on Monday, they asked of help from South Korea. And they said, no, they should go and solve their problem. Because they know that the government are the problem of this country. Our government, they are the problem that we are facing today. That is the main thing.
Okay, now I've been wanting to ask this question before, and I feel that today is the best day to ask it, because we are seeing our economic situation in Nigeria degrading by the day. So I want to ask, this poverty in Nigeria, is it the fault of the elites that we have in Nigeria, or the fault of our so-called political leaders?
The problem of poverty in Nigeria today is the cause of our leaders.
The political leaders?
The political leaders. They are the problem.
Because, but why do you feel like that?
Why I say so is because when the president will be increasing, do you know that when fuel, the economy increase, when you increase fuel, you are increasing, you are creating more poverty in the land. But let me tell you now, if now they are selling fuel per liter 100 and something, right? Now, if we bring liter of fuel to 50 naira, believe you me, a bag of garri or a bag of rice will come to 6,000 naira. Bring fuel price to 50 naira or 30 naira, a bag of rice will come down to 6,000 or 5,000 naira. Because that is the economy. That is what, that is our resources. When you bring it down, then you are eliminating poverty in the land. But when things get increased, and our leaders, they are not care whether the masses are dying, people are crying all over because things are very expensive, because things are getting increased day by day. Look at how much they are selling bag of cement today. Bag of cement is up to 4,000 something. Then how much is bag of cement during the time of Jonathan? Because the price of fuel was little to compare now. So look at a little country here in Benin. They are selling a bag of cement for 800 naira. So why must they buy a bag of cement in Nigeria, 4,000 something? A producing country, we are producing cement in this country, and we are selling bag of cement for 4,000. So where are we going? Who is deceiving who? Then there is no competition, and people are suffering. Look at now, nobody can, you cannot even go drink, everything is getting increased. Nobody, you cannot even eat meat, you cannot eat fish. A little fish now is up to 1,000 to 800 naira. So a family of five or six, how are they going to survive? How much is spent of garri today? How much is bag of rice today? So how are we going to survive? Because things are very expensive. So it's our rulers. They are the ones that are killing this country, defrozen this country. All the time, what they are there after is to loot and loot and loot and take it outside the country. And those countries will use the money to develop their country, to make their economy to be good. Because we don't see our leaders, they are not thinking good for the people of this country. They are not, because they have the money. So even though bag of rice is 100,000 naira, they can afford it. They don't have anything to lose. That is why they are intimidating, they are killing people of this country. So it's time for the people of this country to rise in mass, like the time of Ensign, they rise in mass. Because this time is not time to agitate without weapon. Now we have to carry weapon and go after these people, eliminate them. Look at what happened in Ghana. Roy eliminated all the people that are killing that country, eliminated all of them before Ghana became what it is today. Look at Ghana today. To compare what is happening in Nigeria. Every day looting, our leader, they are not even doing anything. There is no day that we hear the price of this is down. It's only increased. What we are hearing, we never hear any good news in this country. What we are hearing is looting and looting and killing every day, banditry here, banditry there. So because of the poverty that is in the land, if you and I are fine, there's nobody, you cannot even handle gun. If somebody give you gun to go and invade somewhere, you say no, because your life is important, because of hunger. When somebody give you 2 million now, if you give me 5-10 million now, you say go and do something like that, I will go because I don't have the money. As long as there is weapon in my hand, I will go and do it. It's because of hunger, that is why you see things are happening, all kinds of things are happening in Nigeria. People are crying, people are dying every day. What is happening? Can you imagine doctors going on strike? They cannot even pay. Our government cannot even pay workers. They cannot even pay teachers. People are suffering. So if these people that are out there, a lot of jobless people come out from the university, there is no work. Our government cannot even plan to build infrastructure in Nigeria so that people will work. You see people trooping to outside country.
If you are in an outside country, you finish your university, there is no immediate, the job is waiting for you. But Nigeria here, you see a graduate riding Okada, selling tomatoes, selling foods, selling scrap, doing conductor. A graduate, there is no job. They are not even planning to build infrastructure all over Nigeria so that people will work. When you are not working, what else that is in your mind? Is to steal, is to do robbery, to do anything that is harmful to the country. The country will not develop. They are not developing our country. Look at all over Nigeria. Nigeria is the worst dustbin on this planet Earth that I ever see. Look at all over Nigeria. The street, you know, it's not high. Everywhere is dirty. And our president, they are looting. Look at China. Now Nigeria, they will invite China to come and build railway, build this, build that. Look at how what China is. China, do they have oil? It's manpower. What they produce is what they use to develop China. Look at Hong Kong. Do they have oil? Look at, it's what they produce by themselves is what they use to develop that country. And the same thing with Japan and Korea, South Korea. Nigeria have oil. We are not even thinking anything good for this country. It's only to loot the money. Loot and loot and loot. They will loot, their grandchildren will loot. Everything is looting in this country. There is no plan, they don't have any agenda in this country to develop this country. People are running helter-skelter all the time. What is happening? What we hear every day is killing, banditry, kidnapping, and they will be negotiating. How can you be negotiating with a criminal? The worst terrorists on this planet Earth will be negotiating with them. Why they know where they are? They will not go and invade them, bring them to book and kill them, slaughter them by hanging. Our government, they are not doing anything. They are not interested about that. They are not interested how people are suffering in this country. What they are interested is to loot and loot and loot. And they will be in Asura collecting billions of naira all every day. And people are dying in hunger in Nigeria. They are not care what is happening. They are not care how people are dying, how Boko Haram and the herdsmen are killing people. They are not care about that. What they care is to loot to their 30 generation. So how the country is going to grow? So people must agitate. People must agitate. There is no way they can stop agitating in this country. The country have already divided because of what is happening in this country. We are not free. We are not free anymore. Nobody is free. Everywhere, curfew. They are putting curfew everywhere because of what is happening. People are dying. People are not afraid to die. But before, people would be afraid to die. I don't want to die. Now people are coming. They are coming out in mass to agitate, to do whatever they like because the government have failed us. And we know we don't have any presidency because if you have any president there, the president will come out and speak on the Boko Haram and what is happening in this country. We don't have any president. What they are telling us is presidency. Presidents need, I don't think that these people go to school. They say they go to school, they are sitting there in the Aso Rock, collecting money every day, and they are telling us the people of Nigeria presidency. What do you mean by president? Presidency means there are many. It's not only one person. So who are they deceiving? So we don't see anything. There is no light in the country. A country of 60 years, there's no light. People are suffering. No job. Everybody is just looking. No, doing boy everywhere. What is happening? When this country is going to be better? Since I was born till now, I have never seen anything, any good thing in this country. So the best thing is to divide this country. Let every ethnic, let every region go their way and manage their resources, whether you have or you don't have, you manage it. That is why you see agitation everywhere. There is no way this agitation will stop because that is what the Nigeria have done. Nigeria have caused bleeding to the heart of people in this country because the Fulanis, they have already divided this country and they are planning to take over. So now they are saying the herdsmen, the Boko Haram, they are manned their flag. Meaning they are in their own country. They are the ones that are managing that state everything now. So now you don't have anything to say and the government keep quiet. They have not spoken anything concerning that. So when all this is, so then if Boko Haram have manned their flag, then they should leave Oduduwa and Biafra to go and man their flag. That is all.
Thank you very much for watching our show. This is the Political Matters on OPG TV, and we are here by the newspaper stand. We've gotten our interviewees' reactions concerning the stories that we're putting in front of him today. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share our videos. And before I forget, our interviewee said that this agitation would not stop unless the economic situation in Nigeria moves forward. So let's hope that this economic situation that he's talking about will be able to move forward as the time goes by. My name is Alagbe Kayode, and the person behind the camera today, Mr. Ife Johnson, from every member of the OPTV crew, we say bye-bye.